designing is an emergency vehicle detection system for hearing impaired drivers or other motorists, so that we can detect and alert the driver before they see the siren or hear the siren or see the lights.
Our project works, sir, there are two components that we are trying to handle. One being the siren frequency with which the emergency vehicle emit their siren sound. And to turn on the red lights to green lights in case of emergency.
But over here, I spoke with Tomar, who is the company that actually builds the preemption systems for intersections. And they agreed to give us this. This is the actual emitter used on emergency vehicles. And it's mounted to this rechargeable battery so that we can use it for our testing. And this emits the signal at 14, or emits a light at 14 hertz, as well as infrared light. And so we can use the actual emitter used on the vehicles to also test our circuit.
There it is.
For the lab implementation of the siren detection and the infrared detection, me and Aditya were working on that. And me personally, I work more on the actual siren detection algorithm. So when the ambulance would emit sirens, they would be able to pick it up and give the correct output so the LED would light up.
The same with me. Me and Nikhil, we work together a lot on the algorithm, implementing the actual algorithm for both the siren and the infrared part. I kind of focused and helped out Nikhil in the siren implementation, designing the algorithm and doing the actual implementation and implementing the IR part, IR signal, where we detect the MERT. So that's the area where we both of us, like, we focused on.
Right.
And Mike, I guess.
I worked mainly on the hardware elements of the project. Coming into the project, I had some experience with DSP. But my primary concentration is in power. So I was responsible for building the microphone circuit, the preamplifier, building the IR receiver module, as well as working on the transmitter. So stuff like that, anything to do with the hardware elements. We eventually want to be able to set the framework for further development so that this can be turned into an actual product maybe, or
commercialized
by a company.
Basically, the way we tested our IR algorithm is that in lab view environment, we made sure that the software works irrespective of the hardware. To begin with, we simulated signal at 14 kilohertz.